Morning, my name is Marty Seifert. I'm a candidate for governor. This is my lieutenant governor candidate, Pam Myra, state representative from Burnsville, and the all-star in the legislature. I come from you in the private sector for the last 4 years, and someone up above said, well, what are you doing these days? And I said, I'm working at a hospital the last 4 years. And it actually has something in common with politics. There's some things different. There's some things the same. One of them that's similar is it spends too much money and there's too much bureaucracy. One thing that's different is the colostomy bags walk and talk in politics. Ooh. Thought I'd test that out this morning. The reality is government is too big, it spends too much, it taxes too much, it regulates too much, it tells us what to do, it tells farmers how to farm, teachers how to teach, business people how to run their business, parents how to raise their kids, and they don't know anything about any of it. That is the reality of government today. It has become so dictatorial you can't buy a cold beer before a Vikings game on a Sunday or buy a firecracker on the 4th of July. That is how big the government has gotten in Minnesota. We need to turn that around. I am for abolishing the Met Council. I hope that's okay with this group. When I was out in rural Minnesota, someone said, what do I care about that for? I don't live in Washington or Ramsey counties. And I said, just like we as Republicans cared about the people of East Berlin back in the 1980s, who were subjected to taxing and regulating by the unelected Politburo, we ought to care about 55% of our state's population or who's subjected to the tax and regulatory authority of an unelected Politburo known as the Met Council. And he said, in 50 seconds, you changed my mind. So you have friends who are going to get the job done in that regard. Now, this is all not going to happen. New entrepreneurship, new freedoms, smaller government if we don't win the election. And that's one thing where I come in. I am the only candidate of the six of us who has ever pulled ahead of Mark Dayton. We have 87 counties worth of people ready to do battle to take this guy out and to return back to a smaller government, limited government, more freedom, and more opportunity. We used to be an entrepreneurial state. Medtronic was invented in the guy's garage. Polaris was invented in the guy's garage. Starkey Hearing Aid was invented in the guy's garage. And now, under Dayton and Obama's economy, they're living in mom's garage. They're not inventing things in mom's garage. And we're going to turn that around. So we are going to have a grassroots campaign. And some people said, well, you have college kids with homemade signs and all this going on. It's kind of amateurish. Let me remind everyone that amateurs built the Ark and professionals built the Titanic. We in the Republican Party have been subjected to these so-called professionals who have been bankrupting our party, bankrupting our candidates, plundering the treasury and going back to Washington and losing elections. I say it's time that Minnesotans take over and run these elections and win these campaigns, and we can do that. In my House races, I was reelected with 60 to 70% of the vote. In a district that was carried by Klobuchar, Colin Peterson, Bill Clinton, Mike Hatch, and other Democrats. Nobody knows the fact of the matter more than the people of the 4th Congressional District in the state of Minnesota that you need non-Republicans to win general elections in Minnesota. And so without being squishy or liberal, we're going to have a crisp, good message to contrast with Mr. Dayton. And we will take him down in debates. And we will get the fact of the matter out in front of the people of Minnesota. Just like in my legislative district, we had an Indian reservation, we had a four-year college, one big city and a lot of small towns, just like Minnesota. We will win. If we don't win, we can't govern. And we can't handle four more years of Mark Dayton. And so as we all work together, let's pick the candidate who we can endorse, who can win the primary, who can win the general election. And Lord, save our children and our children's children if we cannot do that. So I want to thank you all for being here. God bless you, and God bless the great state of Minnesota. Thank you for coming.